windmill blades, much the same idea that's been used on American farm windmills for many, many years. So I want to modify that and see how it works out. Right now there's no overspeed control of any sort, so chances of survival would be slim. So I have the furling mechanism roughed up and in place. It appears as if it should work okay. I don't have everything permanently installed yet. I want to put nylock nuts everywhere that I can. Like every machine, there will definitely be some vibration, maybe excessive vibration, so you need to allow for that with securing the bolts and nuts and so on. So the furling mechanism consists of this hinge right here. Normally the rotor bearings would be on this shaft here. I added the hinge, and now the bearings and the little mini shaft located right there, offset from the center that it normally located on. And with respect to the tail of the windmill, when the wind load on the rotor gets to a certain point, the tail will stay aligned with the wind, but the rotor itself will rotate like this, reducing its exposure to the wind, and that should control, at least to a large extent, the rotational speed of the rotor. So next I need to get the legs and the supporting struts and so on assembled. I'll be using nylock nuts for pretty well everything to keep the overall windmill in one piece, hopefully in high winds. The assembly instructions are kind of sparse, but using the picture on the box and the instructions provided, it doesn't appear to be too difficult to assemble the windmill. So I'm making progress with the assembly. I've been using some nylock nuts in place of the ones that were supplied with the kit, but I'm probably going to run out of those, and when I do, I'll be using some thread chemical type fastener to keep everything secure. So the windmill will be set up in a very windy area, and besides the ground stakes that I'll be using, I'm going to increase the diameter of these holes right here on the four legs and put in the eye bolt, and that'll give me an opportunity to put in a guy wire or a guy rope if need be. So I'll be substituting a rebar with a collar in place of these short anchors that were supplied with the kit. And in addition to that, if necessary, I'll use guys right here. I put in these eye bolts to facilitate the connection of guys to the tower. Probably use nylon heavy duty string for that.
Thank you.